Welcome, welcome. It's good to see you. I guess I can kind of see you out there. We are in a candlelit kind of service, but it is a joy to be with you. And those, there are many who have chosen to be able to enjoy this online due to the weather. And I am just so glad we're able to do this year with some of our people, right? Last year we were not, everything was totally online. So we're giving God the praise for that. So welcome, welcome. We're going to be using the candles that you've been given at the end of the service. So if you did not get one, hopefully you will get one out in the foyer area. And again, I am just really excited this evening just to be able to put Jesus at the very center of the season. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yes, it's a joyous time, isn't it? And it's a wonderful thing that we can place him first. This is what Christmas is really all about. Lord Jesus, we come to you this evening, and we're just so thankful that you are our God, that you are still alive today. We love and we worship you, and we're going to worship you in singing and song and just praise to you today as we are reflecting on the story of Christmas. And so we give this time to you. Encourage your people this evening. Encourage us, Lord, as we worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Shepherds and how they heard about this baby Jesus being born. So I'm just going to be reading through it. You're going to be able to see some pictures here, but it is a reminder to of us this is a wonderful, miraculous miracle that took place. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. These were those shepherd boys that, I don't know, they weren't really high class, you might say, amongst the people of the day. But Luke reminds us in this story because he cared about those who were hurting. He cared about the underdog, so to speak. And here those shepherds were just tending their sheep on that one particular night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Who would ever think that the baby would be found, the King of the Jews, the Messiah, lying in a manger? Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." I can't even imagine the brightness and the majesty of not just one angel, but a multitude of angels and the brightness in that dark night. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." Even we hear in the Old Testament that these were prophecies that were telling us that Jesus, the King, the Messiah, would be born in Bethlehem. And yes, he was. So they hurried off and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. Oh, the amazing picture of an angel of the Lord appearing to them, as verse 9 says. Sometimes people put an angel up on the tree because it reminds us that the angels were the ones that were bringing the good news, and they were the ones to say that Jesus is born. And oh, how majestic and how lit up it was. Oh, the shepherds, what they must have thought, that they of lowly estate were chosen to be told that baby Jesus was born. This good news is for the hurting. This good news is for the poor. This good news, we're going to find out when we see the wise men, it's for the rich. It's the good news for all people because he brings us hope. We've talked about this in our Advent season and our candles represent it. He comes to give us peace. He comes to give us joy. And he comes to give us love. And the angels were the bright light in that dark night. And sometimes we're in those dark places and we need the hope of Jesus and his love and his joy. When they had seen him, they didn't just keep this message to themselves. They shared this. They spread the word. They wanted everybody to hear that this child, this baby Jesus, was born. It says in verse 20, the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God. And when we've been touched by the Savior, when Jesus has come and given us hope, when he has come and given us peace or joy in a situation, there's nothing else. There's, as Paul would describe it, it is just mystical. It's miraculous. It's something that's hard to explain. But when you've been touched by the Savior, you too will want to let other people know of this Jesus that you have come to know. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for proclaiming that news to me and sharing with me. I've never seen an angel. That's okay. I've been touched by Jesus. I've been touched by him.
Ooh. Yours is the glory forever. Amen. Yours is the glory forever. Amen. Yours is the glory forever.
Our gifts and our talents for him, and we're just saying, God, you gave us this life, you made us, how awesome that is. Thank you, Lord. Well, so our next scripture that we're going to look at from Matthew, the tax collector. He's kind of that wealthier guy, so he's going to make sure that people know that all come to know Jesus. Luke, that doctor, he's the kind of guy that says, hey, he's even for the down and out. He's even for those who are hurting. And he tells wonderful, wonderful stories there. But here we go with Matthew and just get a little perspective. And these two books in the Bible are beautiful because they depict the birth story. So you can find them in Matthew or Luke. And just love it around Christmas time when you can sit around with your kids and family and you read the Christmas story. You can look there and it's beautiful. So here we go. Matthew 2. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem. And they asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. Many people put up a star. I don't know if you can see this star up on their tree, because it was the star that was shining that showed them where this baby Jesus was born. Again, it's a beautiful picture of the light and the lit up star. So they go to Herod to find out. And when he called together all the people, chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. Of course, people who know the word of God and the scripture, they would know that the scripture tells them. In Bethlehem, in Judea, they replied, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you, he says, will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. The miraculous of hundreds of years prior to Jesus being born, prophets would prophesy of that very thing. How miraculous! Not just that he was going to be born in Bethlehem, but prophecies throughout that would share that he would be born from a virgin and thus being the Son of God, proving it by coming and living and dying and rising again. So the leaders of the church, the priests, leaders, said, oh, this is where it's supposed to be. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time that the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and he said, and I want you to go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go to worship him. We know that wasn't the case. He did not want to worship. He was jealous, for maybe this king of the Jews would want to reign and take his spot. So after they heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, I just want to say this, because most nativity scenes show the Magi, the kings there, that they would be bowing at the feet of baby Jesus, but we know that's not true. And Matthew reminds us of that. They came to the house. He was no longer a baby. They said that he saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. I want you to notice here that they came to worship him. Not the star, not angels, not Mary, him, Jesus. And then they opened their treasures and they presented him with the gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Oh, the picture of what God so longs from us is just our heart. And we have whatever we have. They just happen to have gold and frankincense and myrrh. I can't imagine what a child would think about gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Not much to play with there. After they were with the child, verse 12 says, and having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, The purpose and the reason was because King Herod found out that they had left. And King Herod went and slayed and killed all baby boys 2 years and under in that area. Again, fulfilling prophecy of what would happen. Instead, they returned to their country by another route. Again, Matthew 2:9 says they followed the star that led them to Jesus. And we think of it as light. Like you see these candles, they depict the light. The star as light, the angels bringing light, and we follow that, and they did to the child. And by following that star, it says they were filled with joy. And during this Christmas season, it's my heart's desire that you are filled with joy. If you don't have joy, I just say, come to the Father, come to Jesus. He wants to give us his peace, his joy. And again, coming to the house, it's always good to make sure you know what Scripture says. They saw the child, Mary, bowed down and worshiped him. We worship you today, Jesus. We come to you and we worship you because you are the Son of God, the Messiah.
Silent night.
Have hope for eternal life with him. And so what we're going to do today is we're going to show, and just kind of like a little object lesson, we'll start with the light of the candle, and we're going to dim the room over time, and we're going to see how bright it will be when you let your light shine to share with Jesus this good news of keeping Christ in Christmas. Amen. So, let's see if I can light this. And we are going to just light one person. You just take your time. And I'd like you to stand so that you're only holding your candle. And please, children can, but just watch them. And don't lean it forward to hit somebody's hair, okay? Because they're going to get it pretty dark in here. So just tilt your candle to the one giving you the light. And it reminds us of how the shepherds and the wise men bowed the knee to Jesus. That's what you can do. So you just bend that candle there, and then you share it with the person behind you. Oh, Rob's just going far. He wants to reach lots of people, huh? So don't be afraid. Dark world, a lot of hate, a lot of evil, and our Savior came to change our hearts, and he does it one person at a time, and he changed mine, and I just get goosebumps just thinking about it, because when he awakens you and he does something on the inside, you don't know how to explain it to people. You just know that when you bow at the knee to Jesus, asking him to forgive you, and you say, I'm going to make you king of my life, you just realize, wow, God, I didn't realize you could do something so beautiful inside of me. So we're just going to sing O Holy Night, and we're going to see how long we can hold our candle, and we're going to, this is beautiful, isn't it? We're going to reflect on that beautiful night when Jesus, when God came in flesh on this earth as a baby to fulfill God's love for us.
The stars are brightly shining. Oh.
Are you glad that you have a God who loves you? Are you glad that you have a God who says, I want a relationship with you?
Yes.
Yes. Not everybody believes that, but we believe in a God who wants a relationship so much that he would send his son, Jesus Christ, to this earth to take the penalty for all sin, for all humanity. Praise you, Jesus. Now, once we experience his forgiveness, we experience his forgiveness, his love, his peace, his joy, then we want to share it with others. So lift up your candle. Just don't hit somebody in front of you, okay? So, you know, it's beautiful when you can see all of this. I mean, just look around. Just be careful, yeah? It's beautiful, isn't it? We want to be a shining light. We want to be a star that goes out and says, who is this Jesus? He's a God of love. Who is this Jesus? We want to be a star that shines to a world that is hurting. We want to be like the angels. And when we come together, it just shines brighter. Isn't that beautiful? Yes. And we bow to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. We allow him to lead our lives. We worship our God, and we believe in the God of the Bible. That's what we teach and preach. And you're all welcome to come back tomorrow. We're combining both services. We have quite a few people traveling, so we're going to be there. Some of you are really holding it up high. That's good. So 10 o'clock tomorrow, I have... Oh, yeah. Sorry. We're celebrating Christmas. Yes. We won't see you. Some of you, but... Okay, so Sunday at 10, thank you, honey. He keeps me straight. We need each other, right? Thank you for all of you that made this a beautiful event. If you are a child or claim to be, Miss Susan out in the back has a wonderful treat for you. I know we're all children at heart, right? But, you know, come on, be real. I don't know if she has it for everybody. Ben, thank you so much for leading us in worship. Now, this is what we're going to do. We're all going to blow out our candles at the same time, and you're going to see how dark it is. Okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3, blow. It just doesn't look as beautiful, does it? Let your light shine. Go and have a Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Oh, you do it again. Merry Christmas. Awesome. Meet somebody out in the foyer. Your candles.